amazing.
Look.
Oh, Kitty, this is a model of a DNA. And what is that? Let us explore it in today's episode. Zoom in. DNA, short for deoxyribonucleic acid, is a molecule, a group of atoms stuck together in the shape of a double helix, which is like a beautiful ladder that's been turned and twisted many times into a spiral. It's the genetic code that determines all the characteristics of a living thing. Basically, your DNA is what makes you just the way you are. Oh, me again. Sorry. We are made up of over 3 billion cells that we can't see, and each cell has a job. Some bunch of cells makes up our bones, some our brain, some our skin, and altogether they make our bodies. But how does each cell know what to do? That's where DNA comes in, and like a boss, it instructs the cells what to do. In other words, it is a blueprint for your body. But the important question is, how? How these bunch of atoms acts as the blueprint for all the living creatures in the world, right from insects to cats to humans and even trees? To find the answer to that question, we need to get small, really small, to enter the cell and learn about amino acid first. The amino acid is an essential chemical inside our body and is often referred to as building blocks of life. They come in 20 different shapes and kind. Your body links these amino acids together in specific ways to build proteins. Now, these newly formed proteins, along with other chemicals, combine to create cells. These cells then form tissues that make up your muscles and organs, that when put up together, forms living organisms like you and the bug under your bed. These proteins that build you come in different kinds, nearly millions of it. And each has to be formed in a perfect shape to work right, as an imperfect shape usually doesn't function well. That's why the boss DNA enters and takes control of the situation by telling the amino acid how to make a perfect protein shape so that everything, right from the cells to organs to any living organism, turns out just fine. Let's take a closer look at the model of a DNA. As you can see, it is made of different kind of chemicals shown in different colors and alphabets. These letters are the genetic codes present all over the DNA thread, which is very long and stays coiled up inside the nucleus of the cell. But to convert the amino acid into protein, the DNA needs to interact with the amino acid that lives outside the nucleus in a place called cytoplasm. And because DNA cannot leave the nucleus, the cell makes a copy of the DNA sequence in RNA. These RNAs look a lot like DNA, but are missing one side. They are smaller and can get through the pores in the membrane of the nucleus and out into the cell and enter into a particle called ribosomes, that is a protein building machine. They read the RNA code 3 letters at a time and absorb amino acid from their surroundings and stick them together in a chain according to RNA code to form a correctly coded protein. These proteins then go on and do wonders in your body, like building new cells. So, what is DNA? In simple terms, DNA is a molecular blueprint for living organisms that create RNA, that in turn form proteins that can go on to form the magical thing called life. Trivia time! Did you know every human being shares 99% of their DNA with every other human? Not only that, but you have 98% of your DNA in common with a chimpanzee. No wonder you keep jumping around. It's question time! Today's question is, where is DNA found? Do write your answer in the comments section below and hit the like and subscribe button if you haven't yet to be a part of the Peekaboo Kids cutesy-wutesy family and get a chance to get it featured by the end of our videos. So, here are the winners of the previous episode. Hope you enjoyed today's episode. Until next time, it's me, Dr. Binox, zooming out. No, Kitty, don't touch that. Oh, never mind.
Hey, kids, you liked my videos, didn't you? Before you go, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the bell, so you won't miss out on my latest videos. See you.